Hello and welcome to Style, YouTube channel about digital fashion. After uploading my tutorial on how to register hair in Klo, I have got several questions and requests about detailed step-by-step tutorial on how to export hair from DAZ Studio to Klo 3D. And this video will be an answer on this question. So let's open DAZ Studio and pick some hairstyle that you would like to export to Klo. Double-click on the icon and hair will be loaded to the scene. Next, go to the File menu and select Export. Set up the name and save. Next, jump to 2ds Max and import a saved FBX file. As soon as mesh will be imported, select the hair mesh and delete skin modifier. Pick helper's filter and delete all DAZ bones. Let's open material editor, switch to the slate material mode and pick hair material. If you can see, that mesh consists of 5 materials. If I duplicate material and delete all textures and set up different colors and apply this material to the hair mesh, you will see how hair mesh divided by parts. I am not going to use all of them because 4 of those materials are the same. I delete 3 materials and leave only 2 materials. Apply to the hair. Now I need to rearrange material IDs. I select the mesh with first ID, this one. Press select and go to the edit, select invert. And set up second ID for this selection. Now mesh is prepared and I save the file. Next, select the mesh geometry and rename it to the hair. Next, I need to import a standard Klo 3D avatar. I import female V2 avatar. And I need to adjust hair geometry to the avatar's head. Move it up. A bit back. Next, I add one more edit poly modifier. Go to the Freeform tab and select Paint Deform. And select Shift Brush. And move hair geometry closer to the head. Something like this. And collapse the stack. Now I can pick a good angle and take a screenshot as a preview image. And now I can export mesh to FBX file. Go to the File menu and Export selected. Open Klo 3D, load female V2 avatar. Go to the Avatar menu, Register hair and shoes. Select FBX file and then thumbnail and press Create. I put the file to the default hair folder. Open folder and apply the new hairstyle. Select mesh with the first material and apply opacity map. Do the same for a second material and the hair is ready to render. Thank you for watching this video. Please support my channel by pressing like, subscribe if you still didn't, and share the content. If you have any questions, just leave a comment, I'll be glad to answer them.